And Joe, Vice President Joe Biden, raising eyebrows, telling CNN and a group of reporters he's got big plans in 4 years.
Mm. You're going to run again?
Yeah. I'm going to run in 2020.
For what?
For president. No, so what the hell, man? Anyway.
We're going to run with that, sir, you know. You dropped that.
That's okay. That's okay. No, but I've enjoyed every minute of my time here.
Just to be clear, were you kidding about running for president in 2020?
I'm not committing not to run. I'm not committing to anything. I learned a long time ago.
And boy, that's all it takes. And now here we go.
That's an awesome double negative. Yeah. I'm not committing not to do not that.
Under the category of 7 minutes I'll never get back, let's bring in David Gregory, Abby Phillip, and David Drucker. Who here thinks that Joe Biden is going to run in 2020?
I think he could.
I didn't say he could.
I think that he would, because he doesn't know how to let go of Washington. He loves this place. He's been here basically all of his entire adult life. And more importantly, Democrats are in a bind going into 2020. They don't really have a bench. They don't really have a populist bench. And Joe Biden was the guy. He was the guy who got away this cycle.
Absolutely.
Everybody wanted him.
Obviously, if Hillary had won, this would not be a conversation.
Right.
But I think he looks at this high stakes and thinks, you know, in 4 years, there may be more of a shot than I ever thought. And, you know, and I'm sure in large parts of his mind, he thinks, if only I had been there, we could have turned this thing.
In large parts of Democrats' minds, they're looking at the rest.
You don't buy it. You're not feeling it.
How old is he?
He will be 78 years old.
You know, in truth, his age is one of the only things I'm not taking into consideration.
I was just asking he's
74 right now, but he is strong as hell, and he's got incredible spirit. And his mind has never been finer. But he would have had big trouble if he had been in the race this time around against Hillary Clinton, not just from an organizational standpoint, but he's been there a long time. He owned a big part of the status quo. Right. And
he's run before unsuccessfully.
That's exactly right.
I think what's so significant about us talking about this is it's because the Democratic Party right now, as Abby said, really lacks a bench. We can't actually...
bench, a message. A sense of where they're going to go.
Look, and a message can come from a candidate. A sense of where you want to take the party in the country can come from a candidate. Tell me right now who the Democratic Party has from the ranks of governors, from the ranks of senators, that we can see as a rising star and viable.
Kamala Harris in California is one person.
Yeah, potential. She just got to the Senate. She doesn't necessarily get the most rave reviews.
But I don't know if this parlor game works 4 years out. I mean, nobody would have said Donald Trump was going to be president.
I think that's
he would have.
Or Barack Obama, for that matter.
Right.
But
came out of nowhere.
Correct. But I guess the point is, we haven't seen the next Barack Obama yet. We haven't seen somebody give the speech.
No, I agree.
Any
party feels particularly out in the wilderness after a loss, and then something as surprising as this has left the Democrats in the place that actually they've been for most of 2016, which is dealing with a rebellion among their liberal wing that they put down because Hillary Clinton had enough control. But now it's really out there, and Donald Trump is going to exacerbate.
I think the question is, what influence will Barack Obama have over who the nominee is for the Democratic Party in 2020? He's still beloved across the party. He wants to be active in redistricting, which is a very granular thing at the grassroots level. And I have to imagine Democrats are going to want his seal of approval, and they're going to want to somehow get a piece of his secret sauce.
But I do think, of all the people, Obama probably understands the impact of having kind of coronated Hillary Clinton coming into this race. I think Democrats have a lot of real regrets about that sentiment that she was the chosen one. Whether it was real or not, even her people believe that that hurt her going into this race. President Obama, even though publicly he didn't say much about Hillary Clinton, privately, he was encouraging his backers to get behind Hillary. He was encouraging Joe Biden not to necessarily get into the race. Yeah. So he played a role in what we saw this cycle.
Let's not miss a headline here while we're talking about the Democrats. What do you think the chance is that...